I won.
But if you have a girl, if you have
what
girl,
it's up.
If you have a girl already, you know what I'm saying. It's like you have to balance between the balance between the, you know what I'm saying, between the grind and her, you know what I'm saying, because you got to keep her happy, you know what I'm saying? And if she ain't stay happy, obviously, then she gone. But you know what I'm saying, if obviously she gone, it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? I'll find another bitch easy,
exactly,
you know what I'm saying? I'll hit the club, not like I'm gonna find a wife there, you know what I'm saying, but I'll find something legit, you know what I'm saying? I'll find something to have fun with, you know what I'm saying?
That's true, man. That's real true. The thing is, bro, like, a lot of things should be for free.
But that's what I don't fuck with.
A lot of things should be free. Right. But, bro, you know, if you compare this year to, like, 10 years ago, $1 million 10 years ago. No, listen. $1 million 10 years ago was really valuable. Like, with $1 million, like, you could do a lot of things. A lot of things 10 years ago. Now, with how prices are going up, $1 million, like, okay, you know, yeah, maybe like for 5 years, 6 years. I mean, if you know how to save up your money, then you're good. But money, bro, in this generation is a big problem nowadays. That's all the big problem.
I remember
that's all, bro, inflation.
Inflation, that bull crap too. But it's like, if you, I remember too, back in like the what year y'all were born in?
2005.
Who born 2005?
Me and Zom's 2005. Young boy Thomas 2008 or 2007. Now
I was born 2002. So like 2002. Back when I was growing up, type shit, things were way easier too.
I swear to God,
things were way easier.
It was way cheaper.
You didn't get a bag of chips for $1.
You know what?
$2. It's cheap. Now they're making it, yo, in the future, is why I say we gotta get around shit and get rich type shit and trying to become a billionaire type shit. But it's not gonna be easy for everybody, but we gotta try and really do our shit. But I know in the future it's gonna be 10 times harder. It's gonna be 10 times harder. Everything's gonna get an increase. Everything increases but the fucking payment. Doesn't make any sense. Everything increases but your pay. Your wage. The money you get paid is never going to be enough. It's never going to be enough for you to chill out. It's never going to be enough for you to least enjoy yourself. You know what I'm saying? It's never going to be enough. And this is where the self-deletion rates, you know, suicide rates going to be hit skyrocket. Everything is becoming more and more harder for us. Ridiculously harder for us, and it's quite sad. And the children, they can't even eat like that. They can't even, you know what I'm saying? So, like, yo, it's gonna get worse. It's gonna get crazy for us, man. So, back then was way chill. It was way better. I can't believe it. It's flying by. Time's flying by, man.
Like, yeah, bro. Like, on a real note, like, you don't even understand how much I would give just to be a child again, you know what I'm saying? Just to go back to being like, you know what I'm saying? Being around 8 years old, you know what I'm saying? Going out with your little friends, no trouble, you know what I'm saying? You go to school, you're learning the timetable. Like, you know how that's simple, you know what I'm saying? You got €1 or whatever. You can go buy chips, you can go buy drink, go enjoy yourself, you know what I'm saying? No troubles. You know what I'm saying? Nowadays, I have to worry about bills. I have to worry about money. I have to worry about food. I have to worry about everything. I have to worry about people. You know what I'm saying? I have to worry about what other people. I have to worry about my own image. I have to worry about how I carry myself. I have to worry about my education. I have to worry about making money, spending money, how I spend the money, what I spend it on, where I go, what I do. I have to look out for everything. I have to worry about everything. And back in those good old young days, it's just chilling. Life was so easy. Life was so chill. And now niggas are stressed on the daily. I'm stressed right now, nigga. I have a whole project due tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? I have a test week coming up, bro. Fuck all that shit. You know what I'm saying? I'll do it.
Same,
it is,
bro,
what it is. But it's not like I'm... Same. It's not like, you know what I'm saying? It's like... I was a kid.
No, how it was when he was a kid. Yeah, true that, man. True that. When you know, the thing is, when you're a kid,
I'm gonna go get a bath. I'll be back.
All right. The thing is, when you were a kid, you there wasn't a single fuck you gave. Like, you did whatever the fuck you want, you know. The only thing you wouldn't do is to not piss your mom off or your dad off. And that's about it, you know. You don't care. You do whatever you want. But now, like, especially when you hit that teenage age and once you're done with that teenage age, like, once you're, like, what, 20? That's when life, you know, hits you. When you hit that teenage life, that's when, like, where the stress and anxiety comes in. That's when you, like, start realizing, wow, this is how life is. Wow, this is what people go through. And when you're, like, at the end of your teenage stage of life, that's when like, life really, really hits you. That's when you were, like, damn, I got shit to do. I'm not free. Back then, I was so free. You know, I had a lot of time in my hands. Now, I ain't even free. Now, I'm just studying, you know, working, doing this, doing that. I have to worry about this. I have to worry about that. Fuck it. I have anxiety. I have stress. Sometimes I'm even depressed. What's happening? You know, like, what's happened to me? Why can't I be like a little child again?
Let's be real. Zobs. Black Jesus, 47 Demon. Let's be real. No, don't put them back. Let's be real. All our parents knew the fucking game of this world. Our parents knew
the game. I was birthed into the struggle, blood. I was birthed into the fucking struggle.
No, it's like now you, like, you die. It's like this. Now you die in GTA, right? Now you die in GTA, right? And you spawn, you just spawn in a different area, or you might spawn a hospital type shit, or you might spawn somewhere in a danger zone or struggle zone. That's how life is. And the parents, it's just why I don't understand people. I say, if you're in a bad environment, if you know you don't have enough food, I see different in third world countries. Them niggas poor. They going through war, and people still having kids. Niggas are starving. Niggas still having kids. But our parents, they knew the game. They knew what's up, and they didn't prepare us. This is why I always say, F school, my nigga. And I know, Demon, you know, I know you F with school, you know what I'm saying? You dislike it. I dislike it too. But this is why I say F school, because, like, they didn't prepare us for this. Our parents didn't prepare us for this. They didn't even thought. But let's be real, it's not their fault, because they're programmed to think, oh, this is normal.
We just wired different.
Differently. And then it's kind of too late. You know what I'm saying? It's too late for them. But let me keep talking. It's like they knew the drill, but they didn't even prepare money for you. They didn't even prepare some type of income from when you get older, you have money in your pocket. So it's crazy to me. Y'all been through shit. I've been through it. I'm tipping my moms, my real moms. My mom had 8 kids. 8. Damn. It didn't even set up a bank account for us, no nothing. If your mom would have set up a bank account, or your mom set up a bank account, anybody, your parents, you'd be straight. She did, right?
I am straight right now.
Are you straight? You good. You straight, but you still struggling. That's the fucked up part.
Still not enough, man.
About it. You know what I'm saying? I got told about how life has to work. You know what I'm saying? My mom told me. She told me that life is just fucking dog shit, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? Like, she just told me that, like, if you don't certain point, you know what I'm saying? You're fucked. The moment I turned 18, my mom was just like, welcome to the real world. Welcome. You're fucked. Good luck. You're gonna struggle. You know what I'm saying? I can't really help you legally anymore. You know what I'm saying? I was like, I just say, safe, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. If I have to work my ass off, I'll work my ass off to get, you know what I'm saying, to the top. At all times, I'll do my best. You know what I'm saying? Like, she told me how it works, how, what I'd have to do, but it's not like I was actually physically prepared to do it. You know what I'm saying? It's not like I was, you know what I'm saying? It's not like I got put into any situations where I was like, all right, this is actually preparing me for life. School, nigga, you learned seven, you learned six, seven, eight subjects for what, nigga? I'm telling you, bro, I'm never gonna remember trigonometry. Who the fuck cares? God. Who the fuck cares about trigonometry? Who the fuck 100%. Cares about, on a real note, who really 100%. Cares, bro? And why the fuck
100%.
The subject I hate the most on a real note is history. Why the fuck am I learning about the past?
100%.
About the future, blood. I don't know what the fuck this. I know the Great Depression was so bad, you know what I'm saying? I know the World War II was so bad.